The thinking is, why will I buy the conglomerate if I can already buy the unit? No, let's say, why will I buy a GT Cap when I can buy a Metro Bank? I guess you cannot just buy the index, but you really have to be very discerning of those names. It's not like in a bull market that almost all of them are guaranteed to deliver returns. No, some majority, yes, are underperforming. Others are, you know, doing much better than the rest. So I think you really have to be sector specific. A lot of these stocks still offer very good dividends for around 6, 7, even 10%, no? If you buy into one of those companies in the index, not doesn't have to be the best performer, but probably within the average, you could expect to make at least 20%, given that the index has been trading between 6,000 to 7,000 nga since 2020. But you have to understand, with consumer companies, it's a high volume, low margin type of business. So let's say for an RHI or a Pure Gold, for example, even if the top lines are very healthy, we see a lot of same store sales growth. You know, their margins, let's say, for example, if let's say are 5%, if their margins go down from 5 to, let's say, 4.5, that's already a 10% decrease in their net income.
Let's zoom in sa stocks. Kanina sector, then we go to stocks. Any undervalued stocks that people need to study? Because again, just a reminder for those who are watching, it doesn't mean we mention it here, automatic you buy it. It's something that you need to study, make due diligence. But Luis, anything, any undervalued stocks that people should study?
Well, I think we noticed that the investors haven't been looking so much into the conglomerates. And I think that's for good reason. One is, if the thinking is, why will I buy the conglomerate if I can already buy the unit? No, let's say, why will I buy a GT Cap when I can buy a Metro Bank? And usually the reason for this is the conglomerate should be trading at a larger discount than the business unit. So I would probably look into that, because again, you're buying into these conglomerates because they're at a big discount. And the other thing is, you have to consider is that when the foreign funds come in, it's usually very difficult for them to be very specific, especially for us. And just to be upfront, to a small cap name like the Philippines. So usually they try to buy into a company that would best represent the Philippine economy, no? So they probably look, one, into the index, and second, to a conglomerate company. I think when they become more, I think after they gotten their feet wet, that's when they'll start going into more specific names. But usually they would buy into those conglomerates which they think would be representative of the investment thesis of that country. So I would probably look into conglomerate names.
Right. Speaking of conglomerates, maganda yung sinabi mo na really study it. And as we zoom in sa stock, I'd like to ask some of your takes regarding specific stocks. How about Bloom, where we know gaming has have some resurgence? So any take on Bloom?
Well, it's quite interesting what's been happening with Bloom, no, and which some factors are beyond their control. One is that I think especially a foreign fund, you want to buy into a gaming company where there are a lot of high rollers, no, because they are the ones who really bring in the revenue. And I think they're just a bit, I think from the foreigner's perspective, no, because probably they don't have a as a good feel or read as they just read the reports, no? They don't visit the Philippines, no? I think they're just concerned about the situation with China, right? Again, we're already banning Pogo, so that's one thing, no? And then especially with some of the geopolitical tension they're seeing, they're worried if the tourism might weaken, no? And that brings, and a lot of the high rollers are saying come from China. Second is that I think they've been saying that other ASEAN countries have been wooing these same Chinese tourists so that they will instead come to them. So that's why. But to defense of Bloom, I think they also have been, they've known this, and they're also building up their the mass segment, no, which has been able to offset this. So I think that's why it makes it quite challenged, no, and that's why I think investors have been a bit risk off, no, on the company as of late. I think it's just very precautionary. Hopefully, again, you know, the tourist numbers remain strong. Again, I think we are already close to pre-pandemic numbers, no, in terms of our tourism numbers, and I think we're going to surpass the target. So hopefully, maybe if the tension, I'm hoping that the tensions nga, nobody wants everyone wants the diplomatic, relationships to be strong, right? Everyone wants business. So I hope again everything smoothens out.
Right. You've mentioned Pure Gold earlier. What's your take on it since it has been battered since 2020?
Yeah, well, we have to consider that the 2020 and 2021 were sort of like an outlier year, not just for Pure Gold, though. But again, since it was the pandemic, everyone was buying to Pure Gold because everyone would be pouring in their consumption into the groceries because they really can't spend, right? People were just improving their homes and just instead of eating out, they were just buying into their grocery. So I think, again, with the economy finally has opened up, the competition again is become quite strong. And there have been more players, one. And second is, again, the margin, which it's very hard to protect and it's very sensitive. And I think, we've been seeing this, I think, with the other consumer companies that have been releasing the reports. It's very difficult, no, when you are when you're in a mature state, the best way for you to meet your growth targets is through acquisition. Because if I'm a grocery, no, and then there's several groceries beside me, as a consumer, it's good that I have more options. But if there are competitors nearby, there's going to be a lot of cannibalism. So that's what makes it difficult, no? Every year, it becomes, if you're a mature market, it becomes very difficult for you to grow and sustain this.
Right. Thank you for sharing your view. Before we go to our final words, I'll just bundle this, yung tatlong stocks. What's your take on Ali, SMPH, and AC? Before we go to our parting words.
Well, again, we've seen that the companies actually were recovering prior to the Pogo announcement, no? But I think it's a bit overdone. In fact, I think as a testament to this, especially with Ayala, they've been buying back their stock. So I think the company is already signaling that they believe that that their stock is cheap. I think same with SM Prime, no? I think people were buying into this, and then because of recent developments, not just Pogo ban, the weakness in the US, we've seen that the prices have fallen back. So we think there is opportunity to do some bottom fishing with these companies, especially if the rate cuts do manifest. And I'm hoping in August, it already start, no? Which I think overall, it will be a net positive for the market, not just for the real estate, but for all the constituents of the index.
Thank you for giving your insights. Any final message, parting words for people who are watching in Stock Smarts now?
Yeah. Again, so you have to be very discerning. I think what I tell my clients is you it's one thing na you are up to date with the information and data, but always consider that you have to gauge your expectation with that of the market. So as we mentioned a while ago, the BSP and the Fed might cut rates soon, but what is the expectation of the market? So always align it with those. Same goes with company earnings. Maybe for you the earnings over underperformed, but it doesn't reflect with the price action the following trading session, because you have to always know that there is an underlying assumption with how the prices will perform given the data that comes out. So always I would say use your expectations. You should always have the basis, which is the market's overall expectation with that. And I think that will help you with your timing and which companies actually you want to invest in.
Right. Thank you so much. For those who are watching, how can they reach out to you? Maybe seek help, advice, avail your services?
Well, you can contact us. Actually, we have, I think for those who are in social media, no, we are active, Reaching the Capital, no, is active on our Facebook. And I think if you just want to visit our website and send us an email, just type reginacapital.com. There's some contact information where our offices are at, our telephone numbers, and our emails. Probably I can give it to you so you can flash it later, no, on the screen, so that they can see it and they can get in touch with us.
Yes, we can put the links here in the description. So thank you, Luis. Till next time, we learned so much. Thank you for your insights. Again, guys, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thank you, guys. Thank you, Luis.
Thank you, Neil, and a happy Friday to you.